Morning, everybody. This is a a review of the Door Armor Max kit I got on Amazon. I'll put the proper name in the title, and I'll also tag below where this was tested. Okay, how this was tested is unbelievable. They used battering rams, they used sledgehammers to try to get through a standard door like what I've got right here, and they couldn't breach this system. So it cost $100, but I said, hey, it's freaking worth it. Just watch that video below and see these guys testing this thing. So it comes with all 15 gauge steel parts. 15 gauge is thicker than, I'll give you some context here, it's thicker than a CD or DVD, okay? Awesome, well made. These are all the parts included. Those are your door, your hinge covers. That goes on the door frame. Those go over the door itself. Now, I was not able to use these parts because there was not enough room between the door itself and the door frame. But it also comes with these just big, chunky, monkey 3.5-inch screws. I installed 17 of these 3.5-inch screws. You can see on the test video why it doesn't fail. But here's the item right here. And it took quite a while to get all of this stuff in alignment with the deadbolt and with the doorknob. But I can bust it out a rotary file. And this is a rotary file right here, in case you've never seen one, to remove some of the material and get it hand fitted. One thing that the instructions and all that really don't mention is that you have to remove your original striker plates, because those cause interference when you're trying to install all of this. Let's swing you around here to the door hinge covers. Those are the hinge covers right there. These are supposed to pick up two of the fasteners in the hinges, but my hinges would not allow that. And I tried, you know, switching them out and all that stuff. I know my way around a toolbox. But what I did was I installed a 3.5-inch screw in the hinge, and there's one of the 3.5-inch screws, and you have two additional screws that go on each hinge. You'll see that this system is tough, man. And I also replaced a couple of the screws on each hinge and all of the screws on the hinge side of each door hinge. I'm just making sure, you know what I'm saying? Now, the only thing that I thought was not very cool about this kit was the fit and the finish. In order for me to get all the stuff to align, it kind of canted out a little bit to where the return flanges are something that makes steel stronger, in case you don't know what that is. Okay. The return flange fit fairly tight down here on the bottom, but it protrudes more as it goes up the door. But you know what? I can live with it. I can live with it. I'm not gonna go and cut this stuff off or make it beautiful. I would rather have a little bit of an appearance item like that than weaken the entire kit. But yeah, I installed 17 of those 3.5-inch screws to do this. And I had to take real care to hand fit this because of this keyless door. Because with a keyless door and deadbolt, you can't have any drag. No, none whatsoever, or else it won't operate properly. And well, I had to take some time. It took some time, but here's the backside of the hinge covers. The return flange wraps right around there and real nice. But yeah, other than that fit and finish up on the top, that's the only complaint I've really got. And, you know, I couldn't install two screws through the hinge panel, but I can live with that. So, thanks for watching. Later, guys.